give us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the Lord. Just one word from the Lord will move
us down
and cause a sun to shine and give us peace.
There's a parable about that in the Bible.
Yes.
He said there were two men.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
They came to the priest. Came before God. And they were in the temple praying to God. One of them was dressed like I was dressed, boy.
Right.
He was playing. He had it going on, you know, And he looked over. And I said, I'm going to have to meddle. Come here, Pastor.
Yeah.
And he looked over. Pretty clean yourself. I don't know if I can do this one, huh? Yeah, I'm going to have to do that. I'm going to play along with it. He looked up and said, Lord,
I thank you tonight.
I thank you. For being the God you are.
All right.
I thank you that I pay my tithe.
All right.
All of them. I fast.
All right.
All right.
I'm there in the temple on the Sabbath day. And I look good.
All right.
And I'm glad. I ain't like this fellow over here.
All right.
I'm glad I ain't like this sinner, Lord. But this man said, Father, forgive me.
All right.
A sinner like me.
All right.
Now, who do you think went home justified?
All right. Yes, sir.
He went home with the reward.
That's right.
He went home right with God.
All right.
Somebody's here talking about, I ain't going to go up there.
All right.
Because I ain't like so-and-so.
No, no.
I ain't done like them. They need to go. You know, Sister So-and-so need to come on up here. Why don't you go tell Sister So-and-so, you know she need to come up here. No, I'm saying to you, each one of you examine yourself.
Amen. All right.
You know who you are. Now, I'm convinced that you who are here tonight have received Christ. I'm convinced of that.
All right.
But likewise, I'm also convinced that some have not yet got on board.
Oh, Lord. Right. My Lord.
There's one thing, Pastor, thank you. There's one thing about accepting Christ as Savior.
Yeah.
And it's another thing, sister, about accepting Christ as Lord.
All right. That's key.
Savior says, yes, I accept what you have given me. But when you give Jesus lordship of your life, that says, I no longer want to control my life. I want you to be the head of my life. I want you to be my covering. I want you to be above me. I want you to embrace me. I want you to lead me and guide me. And that's why I'm standing here. Nobody in here can point a finger. We've already talked about it.
Amen.
We already talked about it. Who's going to say anything now about you if you come?
My Lord.
Who has a right to say anything about you if you come? You need to come and repent. You need to come, and whatever it has hindered you, whatever has kept you from giving your very best to him. and allowing him to be your Lord.
Amen.
You need to do it.
Yes, Lord.
All right. That's my appeal.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That's what I'm asking you to do.
Yes, Lord.
Don't let this chance get by you. Don't let anybody deceive you. For the word tells us God is not mocked. For whatever man sows, that shall he also reap.
Thank you, Jesus.
So if you're still trying to deceive God, you better know that God will not be deceived. You better believe that God will turn the light on. But what better to do than you turn the light on yourself? Because if I judge myself, I don't need to be judged
anymore.
If I say, God, Lord, yes, I've been wrong. Now I want to be right. I'm already taken care of. You can't say nothing about me. 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 Because I've made it right with God.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
So each one of you said now, you're saying to the Lord, you ain't saying anything to me because I don't have heaven or hell.
All right.
I can't do a thing. There's nothing I can do. All I know how to do is open my mouth. That's all I know to do. But I'm in your heart right now. You're committing to let Jesus be the Lord of your life.
All right. Amen.
That's what I'm praying. Are you agreeing with me?
Oh yeah.
Amen.
Father, can you see your children here? It's not a matter of can you.
All right.
But Lord, as you view them, as you see the depths of their hearts, you see, Lord, the new commitment that they have for you. You see, Lord, that they've come to repentance. And they're bowed before you, Lord. They're looking to you, the author and finisher of their faith. They're calling on your name, the name of Jesus. They're calling on you, Yahweh, I am that I am. They're calling on you, the Holy Spirit. They're calling because they know there is no other God besides you. Oh, Jesus, you are a merciful Savior. And I'm asking you right now to look on them today, Lord. Look on them because they heard the word tonight. And they heeded the direction of the word, Lord. And they're looking to you, Lord, that they may be made straight. The highways, Lord, that are crooked will be straightened. Oh God, the mountains that will be brought down and the valleys will be brought up, Lord. That they will measure their life according to your will and your word. They are here tonight, oh God, to call you Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Oh Jesus, I'm asking you that you would take their hearts and minds. Give them new energies, Lord.
All right.
And now, your word says that you'll give a fresh anointing day by day. Bless them with a fresh anointing.
Thank you.
Every day, Lord, indwell them with your Holy Spirit anew.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh God, in the name of Jesus, order their steps.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
I pray that you would wash them in your precious blood.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Give them a clean heart.
The calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.